remember, we are still looking at the rules of first aid, and we are explaining the acronym DANGER, which helps us to remember the rules of first aid. We have already discussed D and A. We are now moving on to N, which is never. Never simply means you do not need to leave someone who is unconscious alone. Never. Oh, these are the don'ts. Place in the coma position and check pulse and breathing. Okay, so you do not need to leave the casualty unattended to, as simple as that. You need to always be there until the medical experts arrive to assist that person. Okay, by doing so, we will be saving lives. Okay, the next one is G, which is simply means get. Okay, by getting, we mean you need to call for a medical help, an assistance. Okay, once you have applied your first aid, then you need to call for a medical assistance for further interventions. Okay, because you cannot suture there and then, you cannot give maybe injectable drugs or do the see what is happening inside the body. It means this person needs, or the casualty needs, to go to the hospital to be evaluated there. So you need to call the medical experts. Okay, the next is E, which means examine. To examine, just like we said, you need to evaluate. It's more like an assessment. You look at the degree of injury that has been sustained by this patient, and then make appropriate interventions. Because if the injury is small, you'll be able to know what to apply. If the injury is so big, you will also know how to deal with it. So it is very important to examine the patient before treatment. Then the last one is R on the danger, which is to reassure. Reassurance is very, very important in first aid. You really need to assure the casualty that they will get the best help and that they will be okay. So we are done with the rules of first aid, and now we are continuing to another part. And so it is worthy to note that the completion of the basics in first aid honor will also require you to know the alphabet of first aid. Okay, which is A up to E. A, B, C, D, E. Okay, A is always, B, come, during, emergency. This is very, very important, because you cannot work, you cannot think if you are in a panic mode. So as a first aider, you need to be calm, because if you are calm, you are going to think properly what interventions are necessary. Otherwise, if you panic, you cannot really attend to the casualty in time, and then you can even worsen the condition. There is a first aider must be able to assess, and I've already talked about assessment. Okay, here we have history taking. So you need to understand what has transpired when you are at the scene, or when you have arrived at a scene where the casualty is. You need to have some history of what has happened and what has led to this happening. It is very, very important. Then you need to know the signs and the symptoms. Signs are things that you can observe on a casualty. For example, if the casualty is not breathing, remember we talked about the rise and fall of the chest. That is a sign. Okay, you are seeing, you as a first aider. Or you can touch, like you palpate for the pulse. Is there a pulse or not? That is a sign. Okay? Then there is what we call symptoms. Symptoms are things that the casualty will give you. If there is something that is paining inside his body, like headache and so forth, you cannot see it. You cannot feel it by touching, but the patient or the casualty will tell you to say, my head is paining, or something is paining on my leg. That is a symptom. Okay. Then diagnosis. Diagnosis is just a judgment, okay, based on the history, the symptoms, the signs. It is now a judgment to say, okay, according to what I've assessed, the history, the signs and the symptoms, I think this condition, it is this. Okay, maybe take for example, you can identify that maybe this is shock based on the presentation of the casualty. Okay, that is diagnosis. And diagnosis leads to planning. Planning of how you are going to intervene. Okay, then treatment. Treatment are things that you decide to do quickly based on the prevailing conditions. Thank you so much. We are moving on to the other part. We are done with this part. All right, friends, that has just been an introduction to first aid. You know, first aid is more of practical and it is more of interactive. So I look forward to meet you so that we can interact and that we can practice what we are talking about. Because without seeing what is involved in first aid, and I believe and understand that you can read the notes on your own, and you know, but basically first aid needs you to practice for you to be competent. Even when you are explaining to people, you are really sure that yes, indeed, this is first aid. Thank you so much, and looking forward to meet you.